this morning as I bring a very simple message from God's Word, just to inspire faith in our hearts. One of the important things about our faith in Jesus Christ and our faith in the Bible is that our God is a supernatural, miracle-working God. We believe in that. We believe that God will work miracles in our lives, that God still works miracles. The days of miracles are not over. The God of the Bible is still the God who He said He is. He still intervenes in our life situations, into our circumstances. Faith today works the same, exactly the way it worked in Bible times. Faith has not changed. Times have changed, and yes, it may be a little bit more difficult for you and me to have faith in God because we do have alternatives. We do have science. Science has advanced so much, and technology and so many other things have advanced. The times in which we are living, of course, is very different from that of the Bible times, but faith in God works the same today as it did in Bible times. Amen? Faith in God works the same way. And so what I want to do this morning is just reference one miracle story that took place in the life and the ministry of Jesus. One miracle, and just look, highlight a few insights from that miracle, and then encourage you and me to reach out to Jesus the same way today. Or in whatever situation you're in, to reach out to Jesus and let Him work a miracle in your life. If there's one thing that you can be sure that will get the attention of God, it is your faith. Faith has determination. They were not going to be deterred by the fact that this house was packed and overflowing. They didn't go back. Sometimes we give up very easily. We say, maybe today is not our day. The house is too crowded. Maybe today is not our day. It's so difficult to go there. They didn't let anything deter their faith. Faith is expectant. Faith is determined to get to Jesus, to get to God. That's the kind of faith that gets the attention of God. Forgiveness paves the way for your healing. Forgiveness paves the way for your miracle. There are times when receiving forgiveness opens the door for the next miracle that you need, whether it's healing for your body or an intervention in your life. Forgiveness is something God wants you to receive. And in this particular case, Jesus identified the importance of this man knowing that he is forgiven. The good news is that all of us can have our sins forgiven because Jesus Christ paid for all our sins on the cross. Jesus Christ has already paid for all our sins on the cross. And all we need to do, one moment, Lord, I believe you paid for my sins. I'm forgiven. That sin issue is dealt with once and for all. It's out of the way. Both forgiveness and healing come from the same source, comes from Jesus Christ. Jesus is God who saves and who heals. Jesus is the one who forgives. Jesus is the one who also heals. Jesus is the one who also works the miracle that you and I need. And that's what you and I must understand. That Jesus who forgives is also the Jesus who heals. We must also learn something about faith. Faith is action. Faith is not theological argument. Faith is not doctrine. Faith is not having understanding. Faith is not having information. All of that encourages faith. But ultimately, faith comes down to this. Faith is action. And so faith has to have works, action, corresponding action. You got to do something. So I'm just trying to imagine this young man on that bed having heard. He's come all this way in faith. But now Jesus is saying, take your faith to the point where it can produce. Take your faith to the point where your faith can give you your reward, can give you what you're looking for. Put your faith into action. Arise, take up your bed. Do something, what you couldn't do. God sees you and me acting our faith, doing something with our faith. That's when the power of God goes in and says, I will heal, I will deliver, I will set you free, I will do something that you believe are believing God for. Amen.